Hello and welcome to TutorTube, where the Learning Center's lead tutors help you understand challenging course concepts with easy to understand videos. My name is Grace, lead tutor for audiology and speech language pathology. In today's video, we will explore speech audiometry. Let's get started. The purpose of speech audiometry is to evaluate a listener's ability to hear and understand speech. Let's look into this further. The speech recognition threshold, or SRT, is the minimum hearing level for speech at which a listener can recognize 50% of the speech material. The listener would have to repeat exact words or indicate the exact word they heard. The speech detection threshold, or SDT, is the minimum hearing level for speech at which a listener can just discern the presence of speech material 50% of the time. The listener would just have to establish they heard something. The purpose of SRT testing is to evaluate the accuracy of a listener's pure tone thresholds, which can be obtained through pure tone audiometry. SRT and pure tone average, or PTA, should be within 10 dB of each other. You can see the breakdown of the correlation in Figure 2. The SRT is also used to determine the degree of hearing loss and to determine the presentation levels for supra-threshold speech measures. An SDT test is not typically used unless a listener's SRTs cannot be established. The SDT should be consistent with the best pure tone threshold. SRT testing uses spondaic words, which are two-syllable words with equal stress on each syllable. For example, the word airplane. The audiologist would say a list of spondaic words to the listener, and they would repeat them back to the audiologist or indicate the exact word. The response mode of SRT testing is typically the repetition of the target word or indication of the target word. For example, if the target word is bear, then the client would point to a picture of a bear, or the client could say the word back. You can see an example of SRT testing in Figure 3. The listener has headphones on, and the audiologist is speaking to him, saying, "Repeat after me, plate." The listener, however, hears, "Repeat after me, plane," which creates a false response. A basic procedure consists of instructions, familiarization with spondaic words, a single series of descending threshold determination, which basically just means lowering volume to determine where the client can no longer hear, and calculation of threshold hearing level. The Downs and Menards SRT approach is as follows. Step 1, familiarize the listener with spondee-stimuli. Eliminate words that cannot be repeated. An example list of spondee words can be seen in Figure 4, like cowboy, baseball, donut, etc. Step 2, instruct the listener to repeat the words, informing them that some words will be faint. Step 3, present one spondee at negative 10 dB HL, or at 30 dB below the anticipated SRT or PTA. Continue presenting one word at 10 dB ascending intervals until the listener correctly repeats one word. Step 4, descend 15 dB. This is the start level. Step 5, at the start level, present 2, 3, or 4 spondees. Continue the procedure increasing intensity in 5 dB increments until the patient correctly repeats two words. This is the SRT. SDT testing uses stimuli like speech babble or familiar words. The audiologist would read a list of words and the listener would have to make it clear they heard the word. The response mode of SDT testing is typically a verbal response or a nonverbal trained response, like raising your hand or ringing a bell. An example of this can be seen in Figure 5. Determination of SDTs involves a detection task that is similar to the one used in pure tone audiometry. Listener does not need to identify the material as speech, but must indicate awareness of the presence of sound. Word recognition score, or WRS, is used to measure a listener's ability to understand speech under optimal conditions. Optimal conditions meaning the listener is listening to speech in the quiet with headphones. WRSs reflect a listener's ability to understand speech when it is at a comfortably loud level for them. A listener's comfortably loud level is determined by the patient's SRT results or their pure tone average. SRT is the minimum hearing level for speech at which a listener can recognize 50% of the speech material. SDT is the minimum hearing level for speech at which a listener can just discern the presence of speech material 50% of the time. SRT uses spondaic words, and SDT uses speech babble or familiar words. SRT requires repetition or indication of a target word, and SDT only requires confirmation that a listener heard something. WRS is used to measure a listener's ability to understand speech under optimal conditions. Here are the references I used throughout my presentation. Thank you for watching TutorTube. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to our channel for more exciting videos. Check out our links in the description below for more information about the Learning Center and follow us on social media. See you next time!